So now that we've printed out our templates, we have one of Chirrut Imwe and one of our letters and numbers, name and age. So now we're going to take some scissors and cut these out. And when we're done, we'll roll out some fondant and get started. I have taken an 8-inch cake circle so that I could figure out how I wanted to lay these out, and so I could work out what colors I want the letters, numbers, and then a contrasting star to just kind of break things up. So these will go directly on the top of the cake, flat like this. So to give it a little bit of color variation, because the cake is going to be chocolate, so it'll be primarily shades of brown, I'm going to use black and red so that it coordinates with our character's costume. Get a nice clean cut. One more. The piece is off to the side now. When we take the paper template off, we now have a one, and you will see the edges need just a little bit of smoothing, but that is one thing that is wonderful about fondant, and that is that until it actually dries, it is extremely friendly with little oopses like that. The heat in your hands will work with the sugar and the marshmallows, that's what mine's made out of, in the fondant to make it get a little bit softer, and then you can manipulate it a little bit better. Fingernails work great. Especially on this inside. And normally between fingernails and fingers and tools, it's pretty easy to find something that will work. And just like that, we have a zero.
We have red fondant,
and I have rolled it out nice and thin. And I have my cutter. Press it. And I like to wiggle a little bit, especially with the plastic ones, because they aren't always 100% even like usually the metal ones are. But you don't want to wiggle too much, just a little bit, otherwise it'll distort the shape. Just a little bit so that it cuts all the way through and gives you mostly a nice edge. And if there is an edge that needs a little touch up, you can do that with your finger. We carefully lift it. We have a very nice star. And I'm just going around the edge with my finger, making sure everything's smooth. And there we go. This over here and let it dry. And just so you can see, we now have our star. And a one and a zero. There's our 10. Now it's time to cut out some more letters. Let's see if it'll let me zoom in for you. And there we go. Now, see if we can do it. So what I usually do when I have a bunch of letters so that the fondant doesn't dry, I just do basically the block. Not sure if you can see while I got my hand in the way there. And I pull it aside. I'm going to do this inside first. There we go. A little bit more trimming right here. And we have an R. I'm going to cut out the rest of the letters and then we'll be back with the next step. Just gonna go for the general shape at the moment. What do I do to make you want me? What have I gotta do to be heard? What do I say when it's all over? Remember to keep a piece of saran wrap to keep your extra stuff wrapped in. Okay, and we really need these on here. I'm going to leave the section around the head a little bit bigger so that I can kind of raise that out, bring his face out for some more features.
Is the sky so sad? Is the sky so sad? like them old stars. I see that you've come so far to be right where you are. How is your soul? Well, I won't give up.
It does take a while to do. You just have to take your time and be patient. And always keep the picture that you're going for where you can keep glancing at it, because that's the most important thing, is to keep it looking the same.